In 1961, the United States government and President John F. Kennedy personally recognized the need for special operations to counter the communists. A year later, the United States Navy created a special unit capable of conducting sabotage in counter-guerrilla operations abroad. This is how the SEALs came into being to make a huge contribution to the fight against the communists, including in Vietnam. It would seem to be nothing unusual, but if you look closely at the photos of those years, we can notice two unusual details. Why did Navy SEALs hunt for Soviet RPD machine guns and use it in combat, having previously cut off the barrel? And why were they wearing blue jeans in the middle of a jungle, swamps and mud? So, in late 1998, the CIA declassified one of the documents that revealed what kinds of weapons the Viet Cong were receiving from abroad. According to the records, a Soviet Kalashnikov rifle was first spotted in 1965. In addition to the Soviet rifle, there were also Polish, German and Bulgarian copies of the AK. But most of all, of course, there were Chinese Type 56 models. In addition to rifles, in the mid-60s, the Chinese began to supply complete copies of Soviet RPD-44 machine guns under the name Type 56 LMG. After a while, this machine gun got to the SEALs, and eventually, they started using it in combat. There were several reasons for this. The United States Special Forces needed a compact, reliable, yet powerful machine gun. They needed a weapon that would occupy a niche between the lightweight M16 rifle and the heavy M60 machine gun, and the Soviet RPD was a perfect fit. The RPD-44 fires a 7.62x39mm cartridge, like the Kalashnikov rifle. It is superior to the M16 rifle in terms of firepower. At the same time, the RPD machine gun is more compact and lighter than the M60. This was important for special forces, as most of the battles in Vietnam were fought at medium to short range. In addition, the M60 machine gun did not have a box magazine. The RPD had an ergonomic box magazine that could hold 100 cartridges, making it easier to carry ammunition. But the length of the barrel did not suit the special forces, so they cut it down to the gas block, removing the bipods and making the machine gun even lighter. However, along with the extra length of the barrel, they had to say goodbye to the front sight, so there was no way to aim the gun. Well, in fact, it was not so critical. Special Forces experience showed that during the Vietnam War, the most effective tactic was the dagger strike. This is when a camouflaged unit from an ambush suddenly fires at the enemy from a very short distance. In addition, the RPD machine gun was a great way for a Special Forces unit to hide if they run into the enemy unplanned. Operators armed with RPD-44s simply pelted the enemy with a hail of bullets, so that the group could successfully withdraw. Despite the use of the Soviet RPD-44 machine gun, it cannot be said that there was no substitute for it in the United States Army. The second half of the 60s, the SEALs received the Stoner 63A, a new model of weapon in a light machine gun configuration, which was produced in a very small batch. In fact, the Stoner 63 offered the same advantages: high rate of fire, plenty of ammunition, while being lighter and more compact than the M60. Despite it was one of the Navy SEALs' favorite machine gun at the time, the Soviet RPD-44 was still used. Why? It had one more interesting detail. The point is that any soldier who fought for more than 2 weeks in Vietnam could perfectly distinguish between the sound of American and Soviet weapons. This means that the use of the Soviet RPD machine gun could confuse the Viet Cong soldiers. They could hesitate and think that they had accidentally stumbled upon their own. Using such confusion, special forces had time to hide or simply attack more effectively, creating discord in the Viet Cong ranks. And why did the same special forces wear blue jeans? In the 60s, with the outbreak of a new war, a large number of problems surfaced in the structure of the United States Army. It was obvious that a heavy, clumsy government machine could not solve all of them quickly enough. Then a simple, but very wise decision was made: to leave at least the Special Operations Forces alone and let them operate with the weapons and equipment that they themselves considered the most effective. The SEALs wore army pants until the early 70s, when one of the operators brought the Levi's jeans 501 model from home. Within a couple months, almost the entire Special Forces had switched to them. The funny thing is that after a while, Levi's jeans started being sold in stores on United States military bases, so that operators could easily purchase them. Usually, they wore either the 501 or 505 model jeans. But what's the point here anyway? It's that the jeans provided much better protection from aggressive local fauna and were less likely to tear. At the same time, unlike army pants, they did not create sound when moving around. And finally, the most important thing, one pair of jeans was enough for the whole tour of duty, which lasted for 9 months. At the same time, they do not require any special care. The logical question is, how did the SEALs wear them if they were blue? First of all, most special forces raids took place at night or at dusk. Secondly, Vietnam is actually a big thicket. Sometimes you can even see a man standing at full height behind all the bushes and stuff. Definitely not if he knows how to duck. Thirdly, after half an hour of walking along all sorts of rivers and swamps of Vietnam, the jeans of the Navy SEALs were so dirty that they completely lost their blue color. That's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. This was Casper, and we'll see you next week.